With the Guayanas poll, they wanted to celebrate the anniversary of the creation of Guayanas and the agreement between Canada and the Haida Nation. For myself, I also wanted to really pay respects to the Haidas who stood on the line at Ahligwai to stop the logging. Out of that and a lot of hard work and negotiations, there was the agreement. So, you know, when I was thinking about how to carve the pole and what to put on it, that was sort of at the forefront. For our people, that's a real pivotal point and a real turning point as far as, you know, asserting our authority over the land. For our people, the ocean is as big a part of the landscape, so to say, as the land is. If you look at most of our stories, they refer to the oceans. You know, there's the killer whale people and most of our crests, a lot of them anyway, come from the ocean. The elders, you know, all the ones that we've worked with for language or for stories and stuff, you know, they all grew up fishing. You know, since 10 years old, they're out on their own rowing and fishing. And so all their life stories come from the ocean. But also in the rivers and on the beaches, picking seaweed and the rivers, fishing salmon. You know, there's not really a line, right? Like the intertidal zone comes back and forth, and that's where the seaweed is and the tide pools. And then you go up into the forest, and that's where you're fishing for salmon, but those salmon all come from the ocean, obviously. And they're nourishing the forest. You know, there's not really a true separation of where, you know, ocean ends and forest begins. There's a huge amount of artists on the island at all sort of different stages and different levels of their career, but a lot of people making at least some of their income out of the year from art, carving or weaving or whatever it be. On sort of the everyday use, if you go to a feast, you know, everyone will have their vests or their blankets showing the crests, and at graduation, the students will get a name and a blanket, you know, and it's sort of a rite of passage. We recognize what crests we are, and, you know, my daughter, when she's about two and she's trying to figure out who someone was, an older kid, and she's like, who's that girl? And I was trying to think of it, and she's like, she has a shark on her blanket. I think she's Yuklanis, you know, so she recognized one of the crests to the clan, right? And we were able to figure out who she was talking about, you know, and I thought that was pretty neat for a young girl to figure out. Beyond that, the sort of international recognition of Haida art has helped us in ways politically and stuff, you know, because people know who we are, right? So if the Haida take a stand and, you know, someone in Ottawa or someone in Europe, you know, has a framed Robert Davidson print on their wall, they'll know, and they'll just make that much more of a connection. And I think our political leaders have been able to use that recognition to further our cause. And, you know, again, just a small part of it, but I think the art helps to push that.